Today is May Day, also known as International Workers' Day, and workers across the globe plan walkouts, including FedEx, Walmart, and Amazon.
Well, now there is new reporting that Amazon attorneys persuaded the Trump administration to give their blessing to quashing shareholder initiatives that could safeguard employees. Here via Skype to explain is former senior advisor to the Bernie Sanders campaign and editor of Sirota.substack.com, great friend of the show, David Sirota. Great to see you, David.
Good to see you, David.
Thanks for having me.
All right, what is your reporting uncovered here? Just lay out the story for us.
So a few weeks ago, Amazon essentially convinced the Trump administration to bless its move to block a shareholder initiative that would have compelled the company to commit to ensuring and better protecting workers' health, safety, and union rights in the workplace. In other words, Amazon went to the Trump SEC and said, we have a shareholder resolution from our own shareholders that would ask our shareholders to vote on to force our executives to better protect workers. Amazon went to the Trump administration, asked the Trump administration's SEC to say it was okay for the company to block its own shareholders from even being allowed to vote on that initiative during their annual shareholder meeting.
And wow. So, okay, David, let's first of all, has Amazon responded to this? Do they confirm the move? What does your reporting indicate there?
Yes. So the initiative as of now will not be voted on, will not be allowed to be voted on or up for a vote at its upcoming shareholder meeting.
And so how does this specifically relate to worker conditions and all of the factories that are going on there? What's the human cost?
Well, the initiative was pushed by investors, some of them, some investment firms, asset managers, basically making the argument that Amazon's labor record has created a financial problem for the company. Now, the argument is basically that as Amazon is known more and more as a company that that hasn't treated its workers all that well, that's not good for the company's bottom line. The proposal simply would have said, hey, Amazon executives, you have to commit explicitly to a plan and detail a plan about how you are going to better protect workers' health, safety, and their right to collectively bargain. And Amazon, I mean, the pushback tells us a lot, right? The pushback tells us that Amazon really doesn't even want its own shareholders to vote on that initiative. Now, Amazon claims that they're already doing this. Amazon put out a statement last year of principles on human rights, saying, making a bunch of vague statements, saying that it, supports workers, it aspires to have the safest workplaces in the country. But of course, we've seen in recent weeks that workers are saying that Amazon is not taking the proper steps to actually make the workplace safe in this pandemic. And those complaints, it should be added, come after years of Amazon being accused of being pretty viciously anti-union. I mean, there was a video that came out about Amazon and a training video in which Amazon said it's not neutral in union organizing drives. So this is all a culmination. That's where the resolution came from all of these complaints, and basically saying, hey, listen, we as shareholders, we want Amazon's executives to actually take this problem seriously.
So why would this be such a threat to them if they're allegedly already doing it?
Well, clearly they don't want to have their shareholders weigh in. They don't want to face any pressure from their shareholders to be better. They want this all to basically go away. But it's not going away. I mean, we're talking today on a day where there is going to be scheduled worker walkouts and strikes at Amazon and other retailers about the treatment of workers during this pandemic. We saw Amazon reportedly fired one worker, and I should add, a day after this SEC ruling from the Trump administration came down, Amazon fired that worker for organizing a protest of the workplace situation in Staten Island. So Amazon just wants this all to go away. They think they can make it go away. And at least at their shareholder meeting, they've been able to, I mean, that's the key here. It's not like they're getting their shareholders to vote down a shareholder measure. They don't even want this initiative to be allowed to be voted on. They don't even want to allow a debate to happen.
Wow. Remarkable stuff.
Really interesting reporting, David. Thank you.
Yeah, great work. Thanks, David.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
Mm-hmm. Next on Rising, workers across the country, they're striking today. We're going to tell you why when Rising continues.